Hi everybody, it's Danielle and you're watching Stash. We are here today with the lovely, the very talented singer-songwriter Stacy Barthe. Now, you worked with Common, you worked with John Legend, and a whole host of other people. Mm-hmm. What was that like for you? I know Common is incredible. I can only imagine what that session was like. Take me through that session. What was that like for you?
Well, Common, you know, he wrote one of my favorite songs, which is The Light, and when I first heard that song, mm-hmm. I was just like, damn, I want somebody to feel like that about me.
Right.
You know, it's so much thoughtful music going on these days. I was in a club last night, and these women are bopping to, and it's like, you know, that music always existed, uh-huh. but when that's the only thing that exists, and you're not allowed to be creative or have reverence for women in hip-hop, it's
right.
like, I don't know. Anyway, so he's, you know, kind of the last of the Mohicans. I was humbled by his humility because I was just like, it's you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that wasn't actually the first version. As a fan, I was like, if you had some more time, you could probably. And he just went in and he's like, cool, I'll do another one.
Wow.
I was just
and he
like,
just did it. He was just,
yeah, and
he seems like a person that'd be super easy to work with.
He's
though.
So everything.
Yeah. I can imagine. Switching roles from the hip-hop to R&B, you work with John Legend as well on this. Mm-hmm. And I read that you've been his artist. I think I read that mm-hmm. in here. So you've been working with him for how long now?
About 3 years.
Mm-hmm. And not through Motown?
No.
No? Just separately?
That's through Eddie Blackman, who was his general manager mm-hmm. Of his label. And he found my first EP online and mm-hmm. reached out, found me. And like, you know, played the music for John, and John invited me to come and write for the All of Me album.
Right.
Wait, it's not called Love in the Future.
Love in the Future, All of Me was
his huge single.
Yeah, his huge single. So what's it like to be mentored by someone like that?
I mean, John, again, he's like one of my favorite voices.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember in 2005 when I first heard Ordinary People, I was in college and it was like on this LRG CD from this event I went to. And I just played that song over and over and over again. And so he's another one. He's just very humble and very like easygoing.
Yeah.
He's really spectacular,
yeah.
Actually.
Back to your album. So the content of it is very heavy, and you know, you're known for writing, like you wrote Cheers for Rihanna, you're writing more like for Katy Perry and those things like that, upbeat songs, but then your album is very much soulful and it's very much personal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, were you afraid that the public wouldn't understand where you're coming from through the music? Were you afraid of what would happen next if you bared it all out?
No, I genuinely didn't care because I didn't make it for anybody, I made it for me to
yeah.
sort of, you know, talk. I don't have a filter.
Yeah.
So, you know, for the music that I make for myself, uh-huh. it's more of a therapeutic thing,
right.
and it's about the human condition, so I feel like anybody with a beating heart is going to understand, because I'm talking about things that people genuinely feel, but they don't have the courage to say.
That's right.
I don't care.
Right. You know, do you think you have touched a lot of lives, or I know you didn't care about the public's perception, but...
I know I have, because mm-hmm. I feel like I'm forcing people to face themselves.
Right.
I think it's crazy to think that you're not crazy.
Right.
Because what's normal? I think every single human being, because we're ordinary people, right?
Right.
And flawed. Down.
Mm-hmm.
And so we were raised by people who didn't have the best upbringing most
right.
of life. You know what I mean?
Right.
And even the rich kids have issues and... It's just like, we're all fucked up.
Right.
That's just the truth.
It's true.
You know what
it's
I mean?
True.
So you can pretend all you want, but I'm like, hey, you there. Hey, y'all, this is Stacy Barthe, and I have a new project out called The Becoming. Check it out. And you're also on thestash.com.